Okay, this is the setup for the 24-month damselfly. Years ago on the internet, I read an article, and I'm not sure who wrote it, and in fact, when I looked for it again, I couldn't find it. But he talked about the fact that there's a 24-month damselfly that actually comes out in the spring, and it's almost full grown, very large in size, and it has a very unusual feeding habit. And then he explained what the habit was. So here's the setup. If you can find a weed bed that's about 15 to 20 feet from shore and a shoreline that slowly slopes up to a small area of gravel where minnows can actually live, damselflies, very early in the morning, before the sun rises, and just enough light for them to move, they'll actually move from here into this area and feed on the minnows that are there. So, they do this until the sun begins to shine in the area where they are. Once the sun begins to hit here, it'll heat it up so quickly, it could actually kill them. So the minnows move out, and so do they. They head back toward their weed beds. They usually do this about 2 feet below the surface, pretty much in a straight line. Now the trout know that they're coming back. It's odd, they don't attack them when they're going out, but they do intercept them when they're coming in. So you'll actually see the trout on your fish finder that are just in front of the weed beds, or some are actually on top of the weed beds, like this. And they'll intercept these damselflies as they come in, as the sun is hitting the shoreline. I read about this scenario and I thought, well, that's kind of interesting. So I went, I was fishing on the coast and I found a small lake, and when I used my fish finder, I suddenly realized that I was about 20 feet from shore. There was a weed bed there. There was actually, it looked like a sloping shoreline. So I thought, huh. Now the 24-month damselfly in March is actually almost fully grown. So it's a real dark brown, and it's a size 10 hook, and it's 3X. It's really, really a large fly to work with. So I set up about here, and I cast into shore and pulled my fly toward the weed bed. On the first fly, I caught 17 fish, one right after another. And they hit hard. And they weren't small fish. They weren't the small ones. They were like 12, 13, 14 inches. So they were really nice sized fish. Well, I instantly thought, hey, I got a hot fly, I better save this sucker. So I took it off, and I always tie my flies in groups of two. Same color, but maybe a slightly different variation. I do this because if I lose a fish on one fly, I'll switch to another fly that's slightly different, and I may get the same bite back from it because the fish can't tell it from the original. So anyway, I put on the second fly, and I continued to fish because the sun hadn't hit this area really hard yet. And on the second fly, I caught 18 fish. So within a half an hour's time, I caught 35 fish using this technique. Now, since I found this existing in Oregon, I'm sure there are other lakes that have the same opportunity. So this is the setup that you want to look for. 20 feet weed beds from shore, a sloping shoreline, in the shade so the sun doesn't get it, and as the sun begins to brighten up, then they'll move to shore, and you get on the other side so as not to spook the fish, cast through, and fish in this direction, and you will have a killer time.